Computers used to be humongous beasts when they came into existence, occupying 1,000 square feet area and weighing tens of tons. But over years of technological advancements, they have turned not only petite, but faster. This is because the sizes of electronic components, the circuits, have tremendously gone down over years. Why not take this size reduction to an extreme level and explore single molecules as electronic components whose sizes will be in the order of nanometers? So, Hunny, we can shrink the circuits to the molecular level.
Appearance and characteristics. I know what a molecule is. They're a combination of atoms. They are very tiny, just like water. Very good. Do you know how tiny these molecules are? They're a billion times smaller than a meter.
Oh, but which molecule were you talking about and how big was it?
Her name was TPM. She was 2 nanometer long and 1 nanometer wide. While all the molecules in her surrounding were thin and long, and they were so proud of their aspect ratio. These molecules were able to pass current through them when connected to a battery, you know, just like copper wire does. But these molecules are like miniature conductors because they are so tiny. Now the most interesting part of the story is that a single molecule conducts electricity, not a cluster, huh? The tiny conducting molecule has to be connected to a battery through a wire. But if the wire is thick, multiple molecules will come. We don't want that. We just want a single molecule to come. So the wire has to be very thin. You take one thin wire in a solution of molecules and connect it to a battery. Now, how do you get two terminals from this wire? You just break it from the middle. A molecule could just dance around and eventually come and sit in the gap and conduct electricity.
Each molecule explored in molecular electronics has anchor points that help them bind to the wire, okay? Hunny, think of them as glue points, right? Fevicol ka jod. Most of the molecules only have 2 glue points.
Now, my dear Hunny, imagine a tug of war scenario. Wow, amazing! All those pretty molecules were on the seventh sky for their flexibility and potential application in electronics, and hence the name molecular electronics. But then what about TPM? Was it not conducting current? Our TPM was sad and sick of all the body shaming and bullying. Until Kaliganedi, Venkatramani and Seth decided to study its conductance. Initially, these three researchers were perplexed because TPM was huge and complex. But it turned out that it produces 61 different current values when connected to a battery. You can call them 61 different circuits, miniature circuits, which is higher than most of the other molecules explored, you know? Wow, that's a lot coming from just one molecule. How is it possible, Granny?
You're a curious kid. You definitely take after me.
Remember the glue points of molecules? TPM has 6 glue points, because of which it binds to the wires in many different ways. This particular molecule has presented a wealth of information and opened up new